Hey everybody, how's it going? I love that you're stretching right now. Way to go. Keep stretching. We'll wait a couple more minutes for everyone else to get back on. Hey Olivia, welcome to the party. Hi Ella. Okay, so if you guys aren't stretching or haven't stretched yet, just stretch on your own for right now. We'll wait 2 more minutes until it's time to start. Hopefully, we have some other friends join us. All right, let's get started. We are gonna start with a little bit of abs, nothing too crazy. But we're gonna do lots of turn work today, and I think it's important to get your abs engaged so that they can be connected with your top half, with your lower half of the body. So we are going to do a 30-second plank hold, and then we're gonna rest for 15 seconds, and then we're gonna hold it for 45 seconds. Hi, Hallie. And then that's it. So hopefully by the end of it, you're kind of shaking. Just a reminder, when you do your plank hold, you're gonna be on your elbows, and I'm gonna lower this so you can see me for a second. How do I wanna do this? Can you see me? Okay, perfect. So you're gonna be on your elbows, and then you just wanna make sure that your hips are staying in line with your body. So don't arch your back this way. For trying to let your hips up, you wanna be in a nice straight line, so you're really building that core strength, okay? So let me get my timer out. So 30 seconds, that's gonna feel super easy. Then you're gonna have a 15-second break, and then you're gonna come back up, hey Sierra, and do 45 more seconds. We are going to do a plank hold right now. That's gonna be our little warm up. So if everyone wants to get ready, on your hands and knees, and we are gonna start in 5, 4, 3, just 1 second now. Hi Bailey. We're starting with a plank hold. Ready, you're in it in 3, 2, 1, go. 45 seconds, or 30 seconds. Hold it, hold it. I'll give you some music, makes it more fun. I'm gonna do it like I ain't been done. I'm gonna do it like I ain't been done. 10 more seconds, hold it. And relax. So you have a 15-second break. You can come out of it. And then next, you're gonna hold it for 45 seconds. Then you're done. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, back up. Here we go. Good, keep holding it. Don't come out of it. You're stronger than you think. 15 more seconds. You can do it. Oh, Five, four, three, two, and one. Good. Okay, next, we are gonna do some passe holds. So I want you to find something that you can hold onto that would be like a bar. It could be even a wall. It doesn't have to be anything fancy or the back of a chair. I'm gonna use a couch. And all we're gonna practice is going up into your releve and trying to find your balance and holding and trying to stay up there as long as you can. And as you do that, I'm gonna kind of take a look at each of you, and I want you to make adjustments too. So for example, if you're holding, and you're noticing that you're leaning to the right, your hips might be uneven, you might just need to engage your core muscles. So I need to try to figure out, a lot of people I feel like end up being really soft in their base leg, so maybe it's just that you need to squeeze that base leg a little higher. So I kind of try to self-correct too, but we're going to hold it for about a minute or two. So if you want to go ahead, go up in your passe, preferably if I can see you, that way then I can correct you too. Go ahead and try to balance up as best as you can. Go for it. Good, Ella, point through that right ankle in your passe. Super strong, and squeeze that base leg all the way straight. Good, yep. Good, Madeline, try to lift that knee a little bit higher in your passe, pull it up. Awesome, yes, much better, good. Good, Hallie, if you have something to hold on to, I'd rather you balance right now. Or yeah, there you go. Maybe you already did that and then you're working for your balance, yep. Good, pull that passe up a little bit higher, Hallie. Good, Bailey, squeeze that core, yep, nice. Sierra, that looks awesome. Squeeze that base leg really strong. Good, Olivia, pull that knee up a little bit higher. Use those arms. Olivia Hedgel, where do your arms go? There they are, yep, out in first. Arms in front, Olivia. Good, hold it, hold it. Awesome, okay, you can come out of it. Lexi, a little bit higher releve, if you can get higher up on that releve, that will help too. Okay, next you're gonna go, we're gonna go from a prep position, and you're gonna go up and down, and up and down. So you're gonna stay holding onto your bar the whole time, and we're just working on transferring our weight from your prep, snapping it up really strong into that high releve, arms rounding just like you would in a pirouette, and then it straightens back into your prep, rounds back up as you go up. And what I really want you to focus on with this exercise is going from a bent, flat, front foot to getting it all the way straight, all the way on your high releve. So this is not a high releve. You can push all the way into that ankle, okay? We're gonna do 8 of them on each side. So start in your prep, you're gonna hold onto the wall or your bar the whole time. Ready? Here we go. 5, 6, 7, snap it up and down, and 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 up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down. Good. Okay, watch me for a second. We're gonna do it again. I want you, your prep should be really little, just like you would normally for a turn. So the space between your front leg and back leg should be about the size of one of your feet, maybe even a little bit bigger. So if you kind of space that out, that's how far you wanna go down that lunge. So it's just a soft little plie. There were a few of you that were going like all the way down to a lunge and then coming back up. And I don't want you to do that. I want it to feel just like a prep versus like a strengthening exercise for your legs. So it should feel like a normal prep for your pirouette and then popping back up and then coming back down and popping back up, okay? Lots of you are not straightening through your base leg. Like I noticed Ella when we were doing it, and I think Olivia had Joe straighten through that base leg as hard as you can. So you're not practicing on a bent base leg, okay? So let's do it 8 more times on that side, fixing those couple of things, and then we will switch to the other side. Ready? Here we go, you're in your prep. 5, 6, snap it up. It's up and down, and up and down, and up and down. Smaller plie, Lexi, up and down. 4 more, it's up and down, and up and down, and up and down, and up and down. Good. Okay, turn around to the other side. Look to the other leg. Here we go. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. It's up. Wait, freeze. Sorry, show me again. Show me your prep. So arm out in a strong L. Nice plie. Good. Your outside leg, the leg furthest away from whatever you're holding on to, should be back right now. And then that's going to be the leg that's going to come up. Okay. Here we go. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Step it up and down and up and down and up. Straight that base leg all the way down and up and down. 4 more. It's up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down. Good. Okay, what I would love to do next is I want to do pirouettes. And since there's so few of us on the call, I want to watch you individually. So we'll maybe do like 2 or 3 just to kind of warm up and practice. And then after that, you can kind of practice on your own until I call your name. And then I'm going to watch you and give you some feedback on your pirouettes. So you can do single, double, triple, whatever you're working on. But it'll be the same that we've been working on in class. I'll say 3, 4, 5, 6, releve 7, prep 8, and then as many as you can do, landing it really strong, okay? Just be careful of your space, even if you're on, like if you're on the hardwood floor, remember that you don't need very much power to get around nice and slow so you don't wipe out. If you're on carpet, you might need to give yourself a little bit more power to get around, but you should be able to turn no matter what kind of surface you're on, okay? So let's just do a couple to get you warmed up. Here we go. 3, 4, 5, 6, releve, prep, and turn, 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 land. Good, stick that landing really strong no matter what happens. Stick that landing. Try it again, ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and turn, 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 land. Good, and one more and then I'll watch you individually, ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and spot, 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 land. Good. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, you have two options. First, you can keep working on your turns on your own, but also I feel like you can learn a lot from watching each other. So I'm gonna, Lexi, do you wanna go first? Are you good with that? Give me a thumbs up if you're good. Okay, perfect. So what I'm gonna do, I learned how to do this. I can spotlight people. So I'm gonna spotlight you, Lexi, so you're big on my screen. But then other people, if you wanna watch too, and I'll be able to correct her and you will be able to see if she's doing anything wrong or what she's doing wrong. And sometimes I feel like it's easy for you to then fix that on yourself too. So whatever you want, you can either watch or you can work on them on your own. Here we go, Lexi. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and prep. Good. Awesome, good. So two things I want you to really work on. Straighten that base leg all the way. I feel like that will help you feel a little bit more consistent. Your dog's like, I want to turn too. So straighten through that base leg all the way and then point that foot in your passe too. He's like, I'm not going to let you alone. Okay, perfect. I'm going to move on. Well, I'll wait 1 second, see if she comes back. That's funny. I was teaching a class earlier and I had a dog in the background. He was like, would not stop barking. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is not working. Okay, try it one more time. So I want you to really focus on straightening through that base leg when you pull up to that passe, okay? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and go. Good, it's still slightly bent, okay? So I want you to keep practicing and try to really work on engaging through that base leg. Think about squeezing the muscle right above your kneecap. I feel like that's all you need to do is to get that leg all the way straight. Good job. Okay, Madeline, you are up next. Here we go. Ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good, nice. Spot your head a little bit harder. I feel like you could go for 3 for sure. Do that again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep, it's just your base leg. You're a little bit soft in your base leg. So if you get that all the way straight, you're gonna get way more consistent where you'll feel like you can consistently nail 3 turns. That's really, your technique looks really good though. Good. Okay, Ms. Hedgel, you're next. Here we go, ready? Yeah, good. Yeah, just be careful of the stuff around you. I don't want you to fall on it. Here we go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good, two things, Olivia. First, pull your passe up a little bit higher. It's just a little bit low, so I want you to really think about pulling that knee into your belly button. The second thing is when you take off in your turn, you're right now just closing your arms right into a circle. I want you to think about opening that front arm. So if I did it slow motion, you get all the way to a T and then pull both arms in together. They're gonna help you keep your balance. Do it slow motion with me one more time. So go to that prep again. I'll mirror you. Go to your prep, Olivia. Olivia, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Olivia? No? Oh, go do prep. And I want you to open that arm as you come up and then pull them both in together. Yes, yep. Okay, try that one more time, ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn. Good, awesome. Is my sound not working for you, Olivia? I'm assuming not, maybe. Okay, I just sent a note to Olivia. Let's see. Oh yeah. Okay, perfect. Okay, Ella B, you're going to be up next. Here we go. Ella. Okay, ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and turn. Good, Ella. Make sure that you're turning on your ball of your foot, so on your tippy toes. Yep, I want you to get all the way up on your tippy toes. Don't turn on that heel, okay? Try it one more time. Here we go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and turn. Do it one more time, Ella. Get up on those tippy toes. Show me just balancing where you're gonna turn. Yes, just like that. Very good. Yeah, make sure you get all the way up there. Do it one more time. Oh, get on those toes. Yep, do it one more time. Fix it. You can do it. Up. Yes, that was so much better. Good. Keep practicing like that, okay? I want you to get out of that habit of turning on your heels. Good. Okay, next is going to be Hallie. Okay, ready? Here we go. Good, ready? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and go. Good, nice. Nice pull up on your posse. I think you just need to spot your head harder. Like, I feel like you're keeping it really stiff in your shoulders. So press those shoulders down and make sure you have that free range of motion with your head, okay? Try it one more time. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and spot, hard. Good, I still feel like you're ending up back here. Like, so you're kind of spotting, but you're pulling, I call it like the turtle head, where you're like tucking your head into your shell instead of like letting it pop out. So really try to, I think you just need to relax in it, like loosen your upper body a little bit. Don't get so nervous. Try it one more time. 3, 4, 5, 6, relax that head and go. Yep, better. You're still a little bit sipping your neck. Yep, good. Okay, next up is going to be Sierra.
Okay, so I should say I'm having trouble turning on carpet because it's carpet.
That's okay. No worries. You just do your best. Okay, ready? Yeah, go ahead. You can do it on your own count. Good. Couple things. I think two things that will really help you, Sierra. One, straight through that base leg all the way because it's just slightly bent. And then, I forgot the other thing. Oh, I know. Your posse is coming like to the front of your knee instead of to the side of your knee. Yeah. Yep. So pull it to the side of your knee. Much better. Try it one more time. Good. Give yourself a little bit less power. Better. Yep. You're still, you are getting up to a straight base leg. And I feel like by your second turn, you're letting it soften and that's what's causing you to fall out of it. So you just have to keep that base leg really, really strong. Okay. Keep practicing on your own. And next up is Bailey. Here we go. And I saw your note, Bailey. That's okay. Just do it as best you can. Okay. Don't run into that forklift next to you. Okay, here we go. Ready? Yep, on your own. Good. I can't see your head. I can't tell if you're spotting, but the one thing I can see is your base leg. So squeeze that knee all the way straight. Think tall like a giraffe, okay? Try it again. Better. Good. Yep, try it one more time. Go for 3. Good. Yep. keep squeezing through that base leg. That will help you a lot. Did I get everyone? I want to make sure I didn't miss anyone. I think I did. Yell at me if I missed you. I think I got you. Okay. You tell me what you want to do next. Leaps or alsacones? If you want to do leaps, hold up a number one. If you want to do alsacones, hold up a number two. One. Okay, it looks like most people want to do leaps. Wait, is that what I said for number one? No, I forgot. Leaps. Okay, so we're going to do a leaping drill. You are going to take two runs, so you don't need a lot of space for this one. You're going to take two runs. Your arms are going to be first. You're going to go run, run, passe. So you're going to hit that passe, and your bottom leg is going to be in plie as if you're going into a leap. I'm going to take this off so I don't trip myself. So you're going to run, run, passe. And then from there, you're going to try to split your leg straight up and land on that front foot. So the leg that's in passe is going to go forward, and then you're going to land on that leg. So this takes a ton of muscle because we're taking out your momentum, and we're just trying to pop those legs up to build up your strength. So again, taking two runs. Run, run, passe up, and then land down, okay? Let's try it. We're going to do it four times. Here we go. Five, six, seven, eight. It's run, run, passe, jump. Good. Try to snap those legs up as high as you can. Your goal is to get a full split. Try it again. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. Run, run, passe, jump. Good. Again, two more times.
Question, are we like pausing in between the passe and the jump?
Yes, you have a moment of freezing, and then from there, you're really trying to build the strength out of your left leg to pop up off the ground. Two more times, ready? Good, control those arms, Madeline, try to keep them right in that L. Five, six, seven, eight, run, run, passe, up. Good, nice, you guys, good, good, good. One last time. Here we go, five, six, seven, eight, run, run, passe, up. Good. Okay, now we're gonna go straight into legs. So I still want you to really focus on, oh my gosh, slow down, Brittany. Now we're gonna go into a regular leap. I still want you to really focus on that passe, like how you're just exaggerating it. So as you go, I still want you to go run, run, and up. So I want you to really think about getting through that passe and snapping those legs up nice and strong, okay? I'll put on music so I don't have to talk so much. Do, 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 do. Classic. Here we go. So a lot of this have to go run, run, leap, land, and then back up if you need to, and then we'll do it again. Here we go. Five, six, five, six, ready, go. Run, run. Straight through that front leg all the way, Olivia. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight, run, run, up. Good, straighten that back leg, Sierra. Left leg straighten. Here we go. Five, six, seven, eight, run, run, up. Ella, point those feet really, really hard. Lexi, try to snap those legs up a little bit higher. Here we go. Five, six, five, six. Ready, go. Run, run, up. Bailey, awesome. That was a good lead. Hallie, I want you to work on powering those legs up even higher. One more. Here we go. Five, six, seven, eight. Run, run, up. Good. And left, let's do two on the left this time. You're gonna run left, right, and then snap that left leg forward. Here we go. Five, six, seven, eight, run, run, up. Good, power through them, snap them up. One more. Five, six, seven, eight, run, run, up. Good, nice. It's so hard. I feel like doing stuff like this is what makes me miss the studio so much. Okay, I want to run your dance. So that's why I really wanted to have a separate class today, because I want to work on your dance a little bit for the last like 7 minutes here. Do you remember all the ending new stuff that we finished our last time? Maybe?
No.
No? Here's what we'll do. I want to play the music from the beginning, and you can just do it as best you can in the space that you have. I think the biggest thing that I've noticed with other classes this week is I feel like because you're not at the studio, like you're at your house, it makes you feel like you can mark things, but I don't want you to mark, like I still want you to hit everything super strong like you would at class. So you don't get in the habit of doing it small and sloppy, okay? So try to do everything. The things that you would obviously be careful for are like your leaps, and obviously you don't have a lot of room to travel, but like your arms and your power and your faces and like your batmas and things like that can all still be full out. So I want you to really push yourself to do it full out even though you're not at the studio, okay? So I'm gonna play it and just do it as best you can. I kind of want to see where we're at, and then we can go through the ending if we need to as well. So here we go, beginning formation. If I can find your, let's do it again. Are you guys dancing? I realized I had Bailey.
It was kind of off.
It might be a little bit off. So try to, not to watch the screen as much and just do it based on like how you're hearing it. I feel like that's the hardest thing about running the dances right now is the, it doesn't like, I feel like it sounds differently for everybody. So try to just do it like when you're hearing the stuff, you do the, add that count. Okay. Let's try it again. Here we go. So go to your beginning formation or beginning pose.
I don't hear any music.
Do you now, Sierra? That we spent so much time on. Good. Nice job, Lexi. You know it really well. That's why I spotlighted you, because I felt like it was a good way for people to follow, good person for someone to follow. Good. Let's go over the ending really quick. Let's go from the where you push. Sorry, I'll make myself big again. Where you push down. Feel, 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 throw, throw. Let's go from there. Ready? 5, 6, you go. 1, 2, pull. 3, 4, turn. 5, 6, throw. 7, 8, and then we snake through, right? Or turn, drag, turn. 1, 2, then you go in, out, chest roll, boom, drop down, and then, or snake away, yep, snake. Good, then we peel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it was the toe touches, and then you peel to stand up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then what do we do on 7, 8? Oh yeah, step, prep, then you do your double coupe turn. Turn, turn. Do we bring it out or just land? I can't remember. out. T. T down. Okay, T down. Then is it the pas de bourre? Yep, so we did pas de bourre, left, right, left. Then you take your chenet turn, chenet, step, attitude, step through, hit, front. And then we travel to your ending pose. So whatever that was for you, I don't remember what yours is, but if you know your ending pose, then you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hit 7. I believe is what your ending pose is on. Good, let's do it one more time, a little bit faster from the press down. Ready? 5, 6, you go. Feel and hit and step, turn, throw, throw. 1, 2, in, out, roll. Then you sneak away, then you peel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's toe touch. Then you come up, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, step, 7, 8, coupe. 1, 2, 3, 4, then we pas de bourre. Bump, 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 and a shove. Nay, step, attitude, good. Step through, then you travel, 2, 3, 4, roll, 6, pose. Good, let's just do that ending a couple times. Nice, you guys. Okay, any questions on that? You can unmute yourself if you have, if you're confused on any of those parts. Any questions?
No.
You feel good about it? Okay, come up, unmute yourselves. All right, great job, you guys. I just want to say I'm so proud. I am so happy that you joined today. I was like, what if nobody gets on the call? It's like always my biggest fear. But I think you, I love to see that you're continuing to push yourself right now. I know I have said this to some people, but I feel like this time where you have downtime is really going to set, if you're taking advantage of these dance classes, it's going to set you apart from everyone else in your class that didn't join on the call today or isn't keep on, and they aren't keeping on practicing their skills. So thank you for being motivated still, because I know it's hard to stay motivated when you're not your normal schedule. But I applaud you for that. And I'm so happy to see you and I miss you guys so much. If you have anything you want to add in, now's your chance. Anybody want to say anything?
No.
Okay. Okay, then we're going to end like we normally do. Just put your hands in. We're going to say Star Jazz on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Star Jazz. Good job, you guys. See ya next time. Bye. Have a happy Easter.
You too.
Thanks.